Hello everybody and welcome back to Simulate Gaming and welcome back to Thornton Farm. Now today, what we're going to be doing is collecting the bales from the last episode, if you watched that one. If not, you can click the eye in the top right corner now. So basically we went around the field in the Massey Ferguson collecting our bales. So today we're, no sorry, making our bales, that's what I meant, and this episode we're going to be collecting them. Now, I was thinking of different ways I can do this, different ways to keep it interesting. And I actually need to have a serious conversation. Not a serious conversation, it's going to last a couple of seconds. But I was thinking about my channel, and I think the way it grew so fast is because I was doing my own thing. I was doing my own thing by myself, how I wanted to do it, etc, etc. And people seem to like that. So today, oh, I forgot my head tracking. Hang on. There we go. So yes, today we're going back to our roots. I'm officially mounted, we're going back to our roots. And I'm just going to do stuff the way I like to do it. And hopefully you guys will enjoy it with me. So yes, we're doing the bales one by one, which is how I like to do it. It's going to take a while, but yeah, it's the most fun way I like to do it. So what we're going to do is bring the Vulture into the field right here, and we'll tab through to the wherever tractor's available, actually. Okay, so it turns out the Massey Ferguson from the last episode is still available. We still got the baler there, look. So what we're going to do is go ahead and pick up the Marshall trailer, which is right behind us, so I'm going to reverse into that. Now yes, this trailer does have an auto load script, but we're not going to be using that today. We will be using the lock script once we've loaded them all up, but yeah, not the actual just driving around collecting the lock, collecting the bells with the collection script. Right, let's make sure we get over here without tapping anything, because this trailer is very big. We don't want to hit the Stuart or anything, or the Land Rover actually. Or the gas tank in that case. So yes, welcome back guys, I hope you're doing well. I'm recording this quite late, as you can see it's currently 18 minutes past 12 and this is a bit later than I usually record, but I've just had a hectic day. We did record multiplayer, and you know what, go check out the multiplayer series, it'll be up on Saturday actually, so I don't know why I'm saying it now, but we recorded it today and it's going to be exclusively on Rainbow Dave's channel, because actually no it's not, I lied, next week it will be on my channel, but this week is exclusively for Rainbow Dave because I've had a change of heart all of a sudden. So yes, if you want to go check out the first episode of Series 2 of the Multiplayer Series, go check out Dave. Ooh, where's our fork? There it is. So yes, today we're collecting bales with the Vulture, like I just said. Let's position this camera a bit better because I know it's realistic to do it in the cab, but that doesn't make it very interesting for you guys. So what we're going to do is, first of all, line ourselves up with the bale from inside the cab. And then we'll actually position the... This bale is not supported. Supported with what? Right, so let's try that again, everybody. We now have the bale fork on. I completely forgot we were picking up wool pallets at the end of the last episode, so we should be good to go now. What I do want to do before we collect the first bale is jump out and lift this up. So now we can get three bales onto here, which is very handy. Just gonna make sure I got the automatic thing turned off, which we don't, so we go. Cool, so now we're doing it manually, which is exactly how I like to do it. Feels good to be back as the original Simulate, I'm gonna be honest. I did go through a phase of just trying to do stuff that I think was different and unique, but I've decided to go back to my roots, guys. So there we go, there's our first bale. We're gonna do one at a time, because I don't wanna try and be a smarty pants. Just while we get into the zone, because if you haven't watched me do this before, the first two, are, like the first couple, I'd say, are usually a huge mess. But we get better and better as we go along. I'm going to do it this way because we're on a slight hill. Not much of a hill, but still quite noticeable. So what we can do... Okay, it doesn't work anyway. Never mind. I was going to say we can lock the bell, which will straighten it up, but... Kind of cheating, but it also didn't work anyway, so that's fine. Let's lower that down. It is a bit wonky, but once we put a bale on the other side, we should be good to go. Come on. Half you get. Yes. Good start. Now, I'm a bit worried because I'm pretty sure it was like 80-something bales in this field. And how much does that hold again? I cannot remember. But yes. We've got to do this quite a lot. This is not the best tractor for this because the cab suspension's glitching out with the trade mod. Not good, not good at all. But this is, unfortunately, the only front loader we have now. We could technically... Oh, we've only got £70,000. If we could sell our silage, we could probably get ourselves a telehandler. There we go, there's the next one. Bit wonky once again, but better than nothing. Now what we can do, this is when I got all the time in the world I'm not recording a video, guys, this is what I do. So I usually, let me just put it into reverse, lift it up a little bit. So what I do when I'm playing by myself just for fun is I'll get the bell. Can I straighten that out a little bit? No, I can't. So what I do is I put them on top of each other and I'll take both over. We can actually get three on this fork, like I said a second ago. We'll see how that goes. Okay. Oh, please stay there. Yes, there we go. And now we'll get this bottom one. Perfect. So now we'll take these over to the trailer. Now I'm hoping these two will also straighten out the one we just put on. If, oh gosh. Okay, I'm going to begin to think this Vulture isn't meant to have a front loader on it because it just cannot handle it. Oh gosh, we have to be a bit more careful now, guys. Slow and steady wins the race here, I think. So let's line ourselves up a little bit better here. In fact, we'll get back the fork cam right now. There we go. Once again, a bit wonky, but the more we put on, guys, the more it will start to straighten out because they will be pushing each other. Hopefully, we don't push them off because that would be a bit extreme. Okay, let's go back into fork mode. Let's pick up this bale here, straighten up a little bit. Now we're going to take one. We're going to take one for now, guys, and that's because I did one on this side like an idiot because I was still getting into the zone. Oh gosh, it's tipping over again. What is wrong with this Vulture? Seriously. So, yes, hopefully. First of all, what we're going to do is push the bottom one. Yes, I know we're missing before people say I've completely missed. We're trying to straighten these ones out. Come on. There you go. Let's back up. Lift that up like so. There you go. So basically, we've got to do this about 80 times, which is going to be fun. So I think I am going to go for the double up bale thing I've been doing. Let's go find some more bales, shall we? Preferably ones that are pretty straight to where we are right now. I'm trying to think. What tractors do we have? The New Holland is not a front loader. The Massey's not a front loader. The Case is... The Class is a front loader. So maybe we'll swap this out for the Class in a minute, depending on if we get annoyed with the cab suspension on this. As soon as the Vulture messes up once, we're going to switch out for the Class because that's not doing anything currently anyway. It's just sat in the shed. In fact, what I'm going to do is turn on the inspector mod. Ah, so T6 is currently out of potatoes. So what we're going to do is stack these onto the trailer. We'll fill the T6 up back up with potatoes so he can carry on planting that. That was not good, Simulate. Not good at all. Right then. So let's line these ones up. Once again, we are going to get potatoes after this. Hopefully I remember, because I have a habit of saying stuff and then just driving off and doing exactly what I was doing. Okay, get as close as we can. I think there will do nicely. Oh gosh. So we are locking these now. I've just mapped out the lock button to here. So once we pick them up, we can lock them. But I'll show you that in a second of it actually in action. What we're going to do is go and fill up the T6 with potatoes real quick. Okay, so now we're in a T6. I think he's... Yes, he did turn himself off. So what we're going to do is take this down to the yard. I'm kind of glad this ran out of potatoes, if I'm honest, because... Oh, there's a rock there. If you have the Multi Fruit mod, you may already know this. But if you don't have the Multi Fruit mod, then you're not. And when you save the game, for some reason, you come back in, and if you've got an open-top seeder, like you can see the seeds inside of the seed drill, usually the texture's messed up. So, when I first started off this game and put the hired worker on, there was canola, apparently, inside the potato planter, which didn't make sense. But it should work fine now we're about to fill up. Now, you may notice a bit of a frame drop compared to usual, guys. That is because of all the bales in the field, which is why we're not wasting any time getting rid of them. folks, so we're going to back up into here. Right, so I'm just going to double check. Yes, okay, so it is potatoes going into there now, so it's no longer the canola texture, which is nice. Come on then. Chop, chop. I've got bales to collect. So there we go. It's actually working this time. It said unknown when we started, but it's actually saying seeds potatoes now, which is very good. 89. 100. Okay. Let's take this back, put the hard worker back on, and we'll carry on with the bales. Now, you may be wondering, why didn't I do course play? As of late, I've been finding the auto tractor and auto combine is a lot better than course play. Now, the only downside to that is I can't tell him where to go fill up after, which is the perks with course play. Now, I'm going to research it because I wonder if there's a way to make it drive on at 0%, if that makes sense. So we use basically auto tractor and it'll drive off on course play after. Our cultivator's still up here. I didn't even see that a second ago. I'm miles away. Right. I need to fertilise that field as well. So we'll get him back to where he was. Don't want to drive over our potatoes. So what we're going to do is go around and back up to where we just were. Right, so where were we? Literally anywhere on the field. This bale here will do. Okay, let's get this one here. Come on. This vulture's not very good, unfortunately. I think I may swap it out for the class in a second. Hopefully not, because I do really, really enjoy using the vulture. Now, here's actually a little trick. Not a trick that I made up, but a trick that I learnt. What we can do is use this bale here to straighten this one up so it's even. Lift it up like that. Should have probably reversed a little bit, but oh well. And now they should be pretty much identical. Close enough. So we're going to unhitch this. Oh, unhitch, but let go. Lower the forks. That's the wrong gear simulator. Well done, sir. Now we could, like I said, do this with three bales, but I do not want to risk it. Well, we could do three bales. Should we try three bales? Oh, we'll wait until we have like a good structure at the bottom before we do that, and then we'll switch over to three bales. Can't wait to get these bales collected though, because it is giving us a dramatic frame rate drop right now. Look at how many bales we got. There's literally about 84, I think the final number was in the last video. Oh, come on, steady yourself, Vultra. Steady yourself. That's not going to be do us very well. We need to straighten up. Now, what episode is this? I think this is going to be episode 33, maybe 32. I'll tell you what's weird about that. We haven't collected bales like this since episode number 2. We think we did that in the T-dub. If you haven't seen episode number 2, after this, I really recommend you check it out, because if you're into baling, or if you're into this sort of stuff, we do pretty much exactly the same thing, but with more ghetto equipment, essentially. Yeah, I think we're using the T-dub to actually use a... to actually stack the bales, and I think the trailer's being pulled on a rented Deutz Var, a really small one. Right, so now we need some more bales. Now that's kind of okay there, so I think we're going to start trying to do three bales at a time. I say try, because we all know I'm not the best at this. Right, let's get this one. Don't matter if this one's that straight, because we can we're taking it off straight away anyway. It's a shame gravity doesn't really affect the forks that much, because in real life, this would just automatically slide down the forks and straighten out. Right, let's do this one. Once again, we're going to lower this one and make it even with this one. So like I said, even though we're not necessarily straight on with the bale on the fork, this one will be, hopefully. And then the one on top of that will be the same, etc, etc. So, by the time we pick it up, we can straighten out before we load it. Put it into reverse. Come on, stay there. Yes. That bale there looks like a nice one. We'll get this one. Now, this probably would be easier in a skid, not skid steer, sorry, a telehandler. You're probably right if you're thinking that. But we don't, we can't really afford one. We've got like £78,000 or whatever it was. And we need to pay for other things before that. So that'll do us nicely here. Let's back up again. This is one thing you couldn't really do in multiplayer. I did it once and it took hours because something's wrong with Giant's netcode, unfortunately. Hopefully they fix that for 2017. Let's go ahead and make these ones even. Can we zoom in a little bit? Yes. Alright, okay. A little bit off there. I tell you what, it is really good being able to control the camera with my head, because it means I'm technically doing three things at once. And they say men can't multitask. Tell them to check. Next time a woman says that to you guys, next time a woman says men can't multitask, tell them to come watch a Simulate Gaming video, because I'm using the fork, steering. Actually, I'm doing four things at once, because I'm using the pedals at the same time as well. So I'm looking around, I'm moving the camera on my head, using the joystick to actually move the front arm, and steering, and in the pedals. Skills, stay on there, please stay on there. Cool. So that one actually worked pretty well, so we're going to pick this up right now. What wrong? Gear simulate. Not happy with that. We're going to try that again. Drop the bales, please. Drop them. Let's jump into the cab for this, because I'm not convinced that that's the best view for that. Right, here we go. Perfect, guys. That's how I get three bales on a fork. As neat as I can. Oh, gosh. This vulture is about to tip over. Oh, gosh. Now, what I need to do is also get four single bales after this. Well, no. We'll get three more stacked like this, and then we need to put one on each of those other twos. This makes no sense what I'm talking about. I know what I mean in my head. Basically, we need to get one single bale so we can put it. What is wrong with the vulture now? It's cocked its leg up. Nope, that's gone horribly wrong. Oh, hang on a minute. No way. Gosh, you... it needs to be moved this way, but that actually worked out pretty well. We don't have the three stack that we wanted, but hey, it's on the trailer. That's all that matters. I love it when I fail, but it works out. It's pretty much the whole of my life. Let's go ahead, lower the camera. Unfortunately, I need to map out a way to move the camera around on the either the joystick or the steering wheel. I don't currently know how to do that. There we go. There's two more there. They did fall off. Well, one of them fell off. I didn't really fall off. It just failed massively. So there we have. How much we got there? 3, 6, 4 on that side. So we need a double stack, so we need a double to make. I'm trying to even this out, basically, guys. So the ones that fell over have kind of messed my plans up, so now I need a double before we start doing our singles. Let's try and find some nice candidates to be our double stack bales, yeah? You look like a perfect bale. You have been chosen. Stay. Yes! There we have it. This isn't going well, but at least they're on the trailer. That's all that matters. Once again, when we're ready to take... Oh, there's a bell there. When we're ready to take them down, we can lock them, which is handy. Right, guys. So, I made a bit of a mess of the trailer. So, what I've done now is just lock them, and then we're going to add to them, if that makes sense. I made such a mess. Turns out I'm a bit rusty with this, because I haven't done it for a good old while. I got lazy. So, practice is going to be needed for this. But, yes. What I'm going to do now, so I don't bore you guys, is do a little speed-up time-lapse thing, because we are not doing 81 bales on whatever it is, 84 bales. I don't know what it is, but we're not doing that on camera. So I'm going to go ahead and do these. I'll be back in a second. Okay, everybody, so we now have our first load of bales. I have gone ahead and once again pressed B on the trailer, which makes them all neat and tidy so we can take them back without any of them falling off. Which kind of defeats the purpose of loading them ourselves, but at the same time, I really don't want to be picking up for a second time, so yes. We have gone ahead and cleaned them up, locked them, etc., etc., but at least we're kind of loading them manually. Now, this trailer is not going to be able to turn around this corner. I think we're going to jackknife. Okay, so that's the first load done. We're going to take the Massey and the trailer back to the field, and then we'll rush some more, I suppose. Our frame rate is already going up quite significantly, so even that little bunch there we just did has helped us a little bit. So let's try and get the rest done, shall we? Okay, guys, so we've just disconnected the front loader here. We're going to move the Vulture out of the way. Like that, and we're going to tab through to the case because we do not want to use the Vulture anymore because it's a bit crooked. Can't actually remember how to put the front loader on. There we go. So yes, guys, the Vulture is a fantastic tractor, but not great for stacking bales, unfortunately. So we're going to try and get the class involved here. In you get, buddy. Come on. Hook that up. And we are away with, hopefully, a more reliable tractor. Let's go into the bale camera real quick. Let's get rid of that. Yeah, this already feels much better. It's just less wobble when you're actually moving the front loader as well. Let's go ahead, pick this one up. We'll put it on top of this one. Like, so I go a bit quiet when I'm doing baling, guys, because I don't think I've ever concentrated so much in my life. Alright, so let's go ahead and lower that. Reverse out of here. Nice one, brother. And now we're going to go all the way around to get the other one, unfortunately, but hopefully it pays out. Right, let's get this third one here. Nope. Forgot to lift it up. Silly me. This is why you don't record at like 1 o'clock in the morning, guys. Right, let's go ahead and drop that one onto here. Nice. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on. No. Dang it. There we go. Kind of. Right, back, back, back. Come on, stay there. Yeah. Oh, yes. There we go. I'm dreading to count how much we've got left. We've been an hour in real life already, so that's always fun, always good to know. So yes, once again, we'll do another time lapse and get this out of the way, because I'm starting to get a little bit agitated with this. Right, okay, everybody, so this is I think it's the last load. Hang on, where's my head tracking gone? There we go. I think this is the last load. If not, then there's probably a bale randomly stuck at the end of the field by itself, and we'll probably find it in a couple episodes' time when it will be worth no money. But anyway, yeah, we're going to drop this last one off right now. Now, we're going to go the correct way this time, so I don't have to do a really unrealistic U-turn in the yard. So I'm not sure how long that's going to be once I've edited it all together, but I want to try and do one more thing before we sign off, and that is to fertilize our potato field that we've just planted. Now, one of them is already fertilized, so we only need to do one. I'm not sure whether we're going to be use slurry, lime, I don't know yet. Cool, so that's the last load sold. I'm just going to make sure, because it does happen sometimes, that none of the bales have gone behind the bale sell point. Doesn't look like they have today, which is good. Cool, no, I think we're all clear there. I'll pack the Maxi Ferguson up after. What we're going to do is, actually no, we're going to use the Massey Ferguson. I'll pack the trailer away in a second. I could have literally done it now, but I'm being lazy. Okay, so we've borrowed John Wayne's Abbey tank again. John Wayne is the farmer. I don't know why I'm making up stupid names. Basically, guys, we've rented this slurry tanker purely because I know you guys don't like when I rent stuff, but this isn't the slurry tanker I want. I know it's one that I've edited myself and stuff, and I'm quite happy with how it looks. I want a different one, which we can't afford just yet because it's like 90-something thousand pounds, and I need to get the cultivator to go with it. So what we're going to do is zoom out. We're going to open up the fill hatch right here. I don't know if that's actually how you fill it or whether you do it from the front in real life. Please let me know if you do, because I haven't got a clue. And we're going to start filling. Now, we don't have that much left in the actual slurry pit itself. But what I think... In fact, no, I think it's empty completely. But what is happening is I think it's taking it from the BGA, because it registers as like a map-wide thing. So we'll probably find it's getting lower down at the BGA, because we do have a lot down in the silo down at the BGA. Now, if it was if I wanted to be really, really realistic, I would drive all the way down there, but this is just a little bit we're doing at the end of the video here. So, I've got field number 3, only around the corner. I think he's got 27% left of potatoes, actually. So what I'm going to do as well, after we've finished spraying this, is we're going to put the T6 back onto hide worker on field number 4. I think that's going to be the best solution right now, because I don't want to waste any more time planting potatoes, because this is like the third episode now. So I think we're just going to go ahead and do it off camera, and then hopefully the potatoes, next time you see them, will be ready to actually be planted. Be harvested, sorry, my bad. Still got to get the class and the Vultra. They're still in that field. Move out of the way, Mr. Cultivator. Now, I am going to do some editing for this video, because this sprayer is really, really loud. But I'm going to do it in third person so you can all see. Okay, let's get onto the field. Now, we probably should have row crops on. I don't think we can do it in this tractor. I don't think any of my tractors can. So hopefully you can bear with that unrealism right now. Yeah, there's definitely no row crops on here. Yes, none of the tractors we have actually have row crops, which is a shame, but we'll try and do as less damage as we possibly can. Well, for all the newbies here, I am not using soil mod. He's completely forgot to do this half of the field. Okay, so we'll do that off camera. We'll just follow this. Oh, dear. What an idiot. So yeah, as I was saying, I'm not using soil mod, but we do have slurry textures. That is the GMK mod for those people that do not know. I've had to put it in the map myself with help from Shy Wizard. So once again, Shy Wizard, if you're watching this, still thank you a lot for doing that, because it's really sort of changed the way the game looks without any of the annoying stuff from soil mod, which is a shame. So we're actually on 0%, which is not very good. So what I'm going to do real quick is get this bad boy... Where are you? Here. Get back into here. I don't know why I did... The handbrake is actually working now. I don't know why I did that. Actually, I probably should have told you this at the beginning of the video, guys. I managed to get my joystick working. Not sure what was wrong with it, but I had to... what did I have to do? I had to disable the G29, and then that instantly started working, which is strange. So yeah. Let's put that on. Now hopefully he starts actually filling it in, the remaining bits, while we go and refill one more time. So what I'll do is I'll fill this up and we'll come back again. Right, guys, so we're back at the field. We have a full tank of slurry. Let's see what Billy Bob's doing there. Where is he? It looks like he is still working, actually. I'll take it back. I was about to say it looks like he stopped, but no, he is still working. Let's go back into third person real quick. And we'll get this girl going again. Good old Abby. Now, I don't think he's going to go any further than that, because that's quite a steep slope he's doing. Oh, he is doing it. Didn't expect that, I'm going to be honest. Now, hopefully we have enough slurry left for the rest of the field. Still need to do that bit that he's doing currently. Guys, wondering about the GMK's business. Unfortunately, it's not just a zip folder you drop into your mods folder. Unless, of course, the map already has GMK. Thornton Farm does not have GMK. What's the Billet Bills map called again? Cobra Park Farm, that's got GMK. Old Streams has got GMK. There's some more out there, basically. But unfortunately, yes. Thornton Farm doesn't, because Thornton Farm has soil mod, which technically is better. But it was too much work for me, so I thought I'd just go with the GMK instead. With, I should mention, Oxygen David's permission. I didn't do it behind his back, because... I'm not sure what the rules are about editing maps, but there we go. So he's missed this bit as well. It's kind of annoying. So we'll do that off camera. We're just going to go to the end of here. Now, luckily, I think we can actually still fertilise the field and then seed after it after. Well, you can usually seed like that. I don't know if the potatoes are the same. Hopefully they are. Cool. So I'll just quickly show you the GMK, guys. For those of you that aren't seeing it, there we go. Literally just slurry textures. That's literally it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please slap that thumbs up button. It really does mean a lot. If you didn't enjoy it, hit that thumbs down button, because that also helps the channel grow, because interaction and stuff. Click subscribe to see more. I've been Simulate Gaming, and I'll see you in the next one. Where are you going?